we talked about constants, photon constants. Let us discuss about photon variables. Photon variables. To discuss photon variables, let us consider some example. Let us suppose that you are given four numbers and you are asked to find average of these four numbers. How will you find average of these four numbers? For example, 2, 4, 6, 8. These are the four given numbers. And you are asked to get average of these four numbers by using photon. In general algebra, what we do, we add these four numbers, 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 divided by 4. So whenever you are given four numbers and you are asked to find average of these four numbers, you will sum these four numbers. After summing these four numbers, you will divide it by 4 and you will get the average of these four numbers is equal to 5. This is just one example. It is not necessary to have these numbers only. You can have any numbers. Not necessary to have only the average of these numbers. You may have addition, you may have subtraction, any algebraic operation. Now, why I am telling this example for photon variable? The reason is, I wanted to tell you what is meaning of photon variable. Whenever I enter two, I have to store these two in one memory location of the computer. 4 in the second memory location, 6 in the third memory location, 8 in the fourth memory location. Okay, then I will take the sum. The sum 20 will be stored in fifth memory location. This sum will be then divided by 4 and the average will be then stored in the sixth memory location. The first memory location in which this 2 stored may be named A. This 4 stored in the second memory location may be named B, C, D, E, F. That is, whenever we enter data in any form, we have to store this data in various memory locations of the computer. And to recognize in what memory location we have stored a particular data, we have to provide specific names to the memory locations. the names given to various memory locations is known as a variable in Fortran. The names given to various memory locations in Fortran is known as the Fortran variable. So it is simple definition. Simple definition for Fortran variable is the names given to various memory locations in which the data inputted, the data read is stored, is saved. That is known as a variable. Now we know what type of data we use. We use string data, we use numeric data. When we use numeric data may be in integer form, it may be in real number form, it may be in fractional form, or it may be in exponential form. Depending on what type of data, depending on what type of constant you are going to store in a memory location, we will have different types of variables. If we are using a variable to specify string constant, character constant, that variable will be a character variable. If we are using the variable to specify an integer, that variable will be integer variable. If you are specifying a constant such as real variable, you have to use there. If you are specifying the real constant, you have to use their real variable. So depending on what type of constants are to be specified, what type of constants are to be stored, are to be saved in the memory locations, we have different types of, various types of variables in Fortran. So if you are dealing with character constants, the variable needed will be known as character variable. If you are dealing with the numeric constant, the variable will be numeric variable. We have different types of numeric constants, and therefore we have different types of numeric integer, numeric variables. Let us first talk about the numeric variables. After that, we shall talk of the character variable. When we talk of numeric constants, there are various types of numeric constants: integer, fractional form of real, exponential form of real, etc. And therefore, there are corresponding to these different constant, different variables: integer, numeric variable, real numeric variable, that may be in fractional form or that may be in exponential form. If the variables are not defined, doesn't matter. The Fortran editor will do the algebra specified in various formula. But as we know, when we talk of integers, it requires small memory, number of digits are few in number, and the algebra can be performed very fast, very easily. If we are doing the algebra of real numbers, it may be having more number of digits, and therefore it may require more memory, it may require more time for the corresponding algebraic operation. And therefore, to save the time of operation, to save the memory of the computer. It is a good practice to declare the variables at the beginning of a Fortran program. It is a good practice to declare Fortran variables at the beginning of the Fortran program. In Fortran, by default, the variables which are starting with this alphabets I, J, K, L, M are treated as integer variables. By default, Fortran editor considers the variables starting with alphabets I, J, K, L, M as integer variables. But it is a good practice to specify the variables, although by default the Fortran editor can recognize the integer variable. It is a good practice to always declare the type of variable at the beginning of the Fortran program. So let us start with the integer variable. Integer variable. The format for integer variable is integer. You have to use the word integer followed by list of variables. List of variables will be the integer variables which are separated by comma. For example, integer in this example, here I have written integer. This is written to declare the variable. So the list of variables is separated by commas. Sum is one integer variable. DIFF, difference, second integer variable. Multi, third integer variable. DIV, division, fourth integer variable. So whenever you supply a value to this variable, that should be integer value. Otherwise, other value will not be specified to this variable. Difference. You have to specify integer value. You have to specify integer value for this variable. You have to input integer value for this variable. Okay. So, integer is the keyword of Fortran which specifies the integer variables. So, many variables, many integer variables can be declared by using the word integer in Fortran. Before going to discuss other variables. Let me tell you the rules of writing variable names in Fortran. Rules of writing variable names in Fortran. The first rule is rules of writing variable names in Fortran. First rule. First rule, variable name can use 1 to 6 characters. Length of the variable name may be at least 1 character long. Length of the variable name at the most may be 6 characters long. So, length of the variable may be from 1 to 6 characters. Minimum length of the variable name will be 1. Maximum length of the variable name will be 6. You cannot use a variable name whose length is more than 6. This is the first rule. Second rule is second, first character of the variable name is an alphabet. Instead of is, let me use here should be. First character of variable name should be an alphabet. First character of variable name should be an alphabet. Other characters. Characters from 2nd to 6th. Characters from 2nd to 6th may be numerals or alphabets. First character should be alphabet. The remaining 5 characters from 2nd to 6th may be numerals, may be alphabets. Doesn't matter. Next rule. Rule number 4. Next rule, special symbols are not allowed in the variable name. Any special symbol. You cannot use any special symbol in the variable name. And the next rule is seems to leave, sir. Foregone verbs are not allowed. Let me repeat the rules for writing variables in foregone. Variable name can use 1 to 6 characters. It means that minimum length of the variable name will be at least 1 character long. Maximum length of the variable name may be at the most 6 characters long. So, length of the variable name in Fortran may be from 1 to 6 characters only. It should not be less than 1 character. It should not be more than 6 characters. First rule. Second rule. First character of the variable name should be an alphabet. It should not be a numeral. It should not be a numeral. It should be alphabet. Always first character of variable name should be an alphabet. Next rule. Characters from 2nd to 6th. That is, remaining 5 characters of the variable name may be numerals or may be alphabets or may be mixing of numerals and alphabet. It is allowed. Next rule, special symbols are not allowed in the variable names. Special symbols are not allowed in the variable names. And last one is foregone verbs. Foregone words or keywords are there. Foregone words, foregone statements are there, which are known as verbs. Foregone words. You cannot use foregone words, foregone keywords, I mean. Foregone statements, which are known as verbs. Foregone verbs are not allowed to use in the variable. So we have to remember these rules while writing the variable names. We already talked about the integer variable name. Now let us talk about the real variable. These rules are same for all types of variables. These rules are same for all types of variables. These are valid for integer variables, real variables, as well as for character variables. The format is this. Real variables. For declaring real variables, the format is this. The word real followed by list of variables. For example, all these are valid examples for real variable. Average, product, name, random. As you see, the length is not exceeding 6 characters in any of the examples, first thing. Second thing, every variable has its first character as an alphabet. Let me write here a few variable names for real variables. I have written few examples. Let us see which are valid examples for the variable names which are invalid one. Come to this one. This example is using all alphabets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Invalid. Because it uses more than 6 characters. Valid. It uses only 4 alphabets and name starting from alphabet. Invalid. Why invalid? The first character is numeral 9. So invalid. Invalid. Numeral. Invalid. Numeral. Invalid. Special symbol. So while writing the names, select the name such that selecting names for the foreign variables such that they will be meaningful at the same time they do not violate the rules for writing the variable names. This is about the real variables. And finally, what left from the variables is character variables. The word character followed by list of variables. For example, see what I have written in the example. Character followed by asterisk symbol 10. It means that variable A and B at the most can have 10 characters. Name C, D preceded by asterisk 25, meaning that the variable name is A, is B, is C, is D. The variable C and variable B can be specified at the most 25 characters long character data. Here, variable A and variable B can be assigned with at the most 10 characters long data. This way variable names can be used for specifying various variables. These variables generally declared at the beginning of the Fortran program. This is in short about the variables in Fortran. And you know what is need of using the variable names. I have told all these things at the beginning of this article. So here we complete the variables or variable names in Fortran. Next article is about arithmetic operations. We shall discuss that article in the coming lecture. Thank you.